This is Jeff Grist with Rod Ripple Unlimited, and we are here tonight at the Mousetrap with Zugma. And how are you guys doing tonight?
Awesome.
Good.
Great.
Good.
So, Zugma, how'd you guys come up with the name and what, you know, what's it about?
Well, basically, Zugma is a Greek word, and it means to join. And we decided to spell it Z-O-O-G-M-A instead, just, you know, for whatever purposes. Yeah, it's different. And it's probably, you know, I don't know. And we talked about it, and we decided that was probably a name that fit. And, you know, not a lot of people have band names that start with Z anyway, so it's easy. People hear it one time, and it's easy to remember.
It's fun to say.
Yeah. you guys just came out with a new album, Recreational Vehicles. You guys want to talk about that?
Yeah, it's our first album. It was self-produced at with our buddy Tom Keha in Oxford at the Lip Studio. And it's free. We decided to give it away so you can get online. It's www.zugma.net. It's our copy for free. We can pick up the hard copy with the artwork from Rob Marks. It's a scene painter, live painter. We're really proud of it, so we want everybody to have it.
It's kind of a culmination, I guess, of like, just kind of where we've been, I guess, as a group in the past, like, you know, year and a half. I mean, we're all, you know, really happy with it. I think, you know, it speaks pretty clearly about kind of our sound. You know, I feel like it's, you know, a good representation of, you know, of our music.
You know, I think I think it's a good representation of, like, the direction we're heading. You know, like, a lot of the songs, a lot of, are kind of the momentum we're trying to move towards is really represented on the album well, I think. And so that's something I think we're all proud of, is that we're kind of transitioning as a band from sort of a, you know, collective that does a lot of, you know, real loose improvs and everything. We're kind of tightening our sound and pushing it into a little bit more of an electronic direction. And we've gotten good response so far. And so I think that all of us have been really happy with it. And giving it away for free seems to have been really helping with us in our tour. And just being sure that people, when we get there, know that, you know, what the music is and can identify with it. And so, yeah, all in all, it was a great experience. I feel like there's a lot of horror stories about recording albums, and we really kind of got off easy and had a great time doing it. So. You guys are currently on tour promoting this album. What are some of the, I noticed that you guys have a large list of cities and states. Where are you guys excited to play, like, the most excitement at what venue or city?
We're going out, actually on this, like, this run here, we're going to, in a few days, I guess, to Colorado. We're going to do a couple nights in Denver. We're going to do Fort Collins. We're going to go to Austin, Texas. It'll be my first time in Austin. Super stoked about that. And we've got, like, the Head Jams Festival coming up in Adams, Tennessee. We've got the Workout Festival in Ohio, Bear Creek, in November, I guess. And we're definitely excited about that one. Yeah, way too much.
We also went to Chicago recently too, and that was cool. Yeah, like, we all just moved over to Chicago, so that was
probably our biggest, you know, city to date. You know, I mean, we played Atlanta and Nashville and stuff, but Chicago was a whole different type of animal. And
delicious hot dogs.
I think it's tough to say though, because all of us, you know, we'll be real excited about a show, and we'll say, you know, this is the show we're excited about. And then we'll do a random stop, you know, like here, or in Bowling Green, Kentucky, or, you know, Auburn, Alabama, and it'll just be something that, or Columbus, Georgia, and it'll be something that we never even expected to be this amazing night, and it'll end up being one of our favorite places to play. And so, I don't know, we always keep an open mind, you know, we get excited about shows, but we get surprised all the time by, you know, people in so many places that we never expected to get a good response necessarily, and so we've been fortunate in that respect.
So are all you guys from Oxford, Mississippi? Or, like, how did it all come together?
Preston and I and Justin live in Oxford. We went to school in Oxford as well, but Ryan and Brock from Memphis. I guess me and Justin played in another band before this one, and we kind of got tired of that one and wanted to do something more experimental, so me and him started jamming together with a few people, and
Eventually we Preston joined. It started out me and Justin and Preston. And another bass player, Ron Wilmuth, at the time. We had a percussionist. And I knew Brock from just back in high school. I called him up one day and asked him to come down to jam. And we were like the feel of it. So he started playing with us. And then after our old bass player left, Ryan joined. I guess that's how we kind of came together. Ron was in another band that played around Energy D. And once Jason left to go to school, we called up Ron. Right? And just, you know, come fill it out, come jam. And I mean, he came in and first session went great. So he joined immediately after that. And I guess we've been together for about a year and a half now. As is, and it's been great.
With your guys' sound that you have, what's like one thing that you like want the audience to like feel, or like, you know, what's that thing that, you know, like you guys are trying to put forth with your music, like get the audience, you know, like get wild, or you know, you guys have like a like,
just think like a rock and more rock element to electronic music. Okay. That's kind of more.
Bring rock and roll to dance floor.
Yeah, we're all about energy. So you know, if whatever way we can get to the most energy possible in a set is, you know, what we'll play. That tends to be a lot of rock, a lot of electronic music.
We got one last question for you. No. I got one last question for you guys. I know you guys cover the Ghostbusters theme. If you could be one of the Ghostbusters, who would you be?
Man.
Thanks,
man. Egon. That's mine.
I would have to do
Rick. Does Rick Moranis count? Yeah, shit.
That's who I would be. I would be Rick Moranis.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. The Bill Murray dude. Yeah.
We got Bankman.
Who would be Andy Potter?
I'd want to be the
Teeter.
The villain in the second movie.
Yeah.
It's good.
Nice.
What's his name?
Vigo.
Yeah.
Vigo the Bulgarian.
Yeah, exactly. We need like a song called that shit. That guy was freaking out.
All right. Well,
that guy lived in paintings. I mean, that's pretty awesome.
All right. Well, guys, awesome first set. Can't wait for the second one. Zugma guys, they're gonna be on tour all across the country to a city near you. Check them out.